Hey everybody, how you doing? It's been a long time since I had the chance to make a good video, and I thought I'd take this opportunity to introduce you to my garden here. It's also a good opportunity to review some things that our class has learned in fourth grade. In the garden here, I've got some peppers, a couple of different kinds of peppers, red and green, and then a cayenne pepper. And then I've got a couple of tomato plants right here. And then I've got cucumbers. Oh, and that gives us a chance to talk about the word tropism. Remember us talking about that word tropism? It comes from the Greek trope, which means to change or to turn. And there's five of those tropisms that we didn't get into detail about at school, but it wouldn't hurt for you to learn them now. There's, let's see, what is it? Phototropism. Thigmotropism, geotropism, hydrotropism, and chemotropism. Now, the one I wanted to remind you about, we talked about, is called thigmotropism, and it's a touch response. All of these things have to do with a plant and how it responds to a stimulus in its environment. And the cucumber is a great example of thigmotropic because it touches a what people call a trellis, something for the cucumber vine to grow, climb on. It touches it and actually grabs a hold of that, and it supports the cucumber as it grows. This squash plant, although it looks really great, it's not producing any squash. So we're going to pollinate this plant, since the bees aren't helping us today. We're going to bee the bee. 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 It's just fun to say, isn't it? Now here's a beautiful little squash bloom. I've got a paintbrush here that I'm going to use to get some pollen on. Now, I've got to find a male flower, and let's see, both of these guys here are male. So I'm just going to gently open up the flower there. Got a little bit on our brush here. Now what we do is find a female flower. Now the female flowers are easy to identify because there's a tiny squash that grows right here on the underneath the bud, and there's one right there. I'm going to gently open up this female flower, get a little pollen in there. I think if you just gently shake it, there's all kinds of particles of pollen that are flying all over that flower. And hey, guess what kind of vegetable loves to watch animals? Well, zucchini. I know that's really bad. I think there's a lot of kids that don't eat zucchini, but it's really a very tasteless. Especially if it reminds you a little bit of a cucumber, actually. Slightly. It's not as watery. Actually, that's really good. If you've had fried zucchini and didn't like it, try a raw one. It's good, and it's got to be good for you. Fresh. All right, one more thing. Students who helped me, I don't mean to point the knife at you. Students! Students. Thanks so much for your hard work on the TCAP test. All that hard work all year paid off, and I want to give you the credit because most of you were proficient and advanced, just like we were looking for. So thanks again for all your hard work, and thanks for visiting my garden today. Try some fresh raw zucchini.